Hi, this is Squad, and in this video, I want to tell you about the JAK-STAT signaling. So a lot of the systems use JAK-STAT signaling, and these systems usually have a commonality where ligand, it could be EPO, erythropoietin, or cytokines that are secreted by some cells, and they travel throughout the body, go to many, many different places. So how do you decide who gets this kind of signal? Well, the decision is made by receiver cells having the specific receptor for this. So usually, when your kidney secretes EPO or immune cell secretes cytokines, these ones travel throughout the body, and somewhere in the body you'll have a cell with the receptor specific to the ligand. So if this is a ligand A, then receptor is going to be A receptor. And these receptors have another protein attached intracellularly, and this is the JAK protein. JAK stands for just another kinase. And when the ligand and the receptor bind, the receptor pairs with another receptor to dimerize. And this dimerization activates the receptor's intracellular side. So here is the cell, dimerized receptors, and these are the JAK molecules now with the phosphate attached to it. And this is now an active dimerization with the JAK activated. Now with active JAK, another protein within the cell comes to interact with this activated JAK, and this another protein is STAT. So here's a JAK activated, another JAK activated, and these two are the ligand receptors, and here you have two STAT coming to this receptor JAK complex. And then the STAT would get activated by talking to the JAK. Here are two receptors, two activated JAK and two activated STAT. Activation happens with extra phosphate being added to that protein, and this STAT can now go to the nucleus and change the gene expression of this cell. And if the ligand is EPO, then the gene expression is going to involve activation of an anti-apoptotic BCLX protein, who's going to work against the BAX protein that's driving the apoptosis of a red blood cell precursor. Overall, EPO increases the production of a BCLX, who's going to go against BAX. BAX is for apoptotic, so BCLX is against apoptosis. And when RBC precursor doesn't die, RBC precursor is going to become red blood cell. So EPO increases the amount of red blood cell. In similar logic, a lot of cytokines can act on specific cells, like immune cells, and trigger their response. And because the immune system uses a lot of JAK-STAT-based communication, people use molecules that go against JAK-STAT signaling, especially JAK. There are medications like ruxolitinib and many others that can target this JAK-STAT signaling pathway to suppress the immune system. And patients with autoimmune diseases or some kind of blood cancer use such JAK-STAT inhibitors for treatment. In summary, the JAK-STAT signaling uses ligands. There are many JAK-STAT ligands, and these ligands are water-soluble, can travel to many parts of the body, be in contact with many cells, but only specific cells have the receptor. For EPO, RBC precursor has that receptor. When the ligand binds to that specific receptor, JAK gets activated, STAT gets activated, and then the gene expression changes to produce specific proteins.